गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन. सो पार्ट टू ऑफ मॉनसून डायरी. ओके नाउ डिड यू रीड पार्ट वन ऑफ शॉर्ट मॉनसून डायरी? ओके वेरी गुड. रीड अगेन. ओके नाउ ऑगस्ट टू. दिस इज अबाउट ऑगस्ट टू. द राइटर राइट्स अबाउट 2nd August. ऑल दैट हैपेंड, ऑल दैट ही सॉ. ओके ऑल नाइट द रेन हैज बीन ड्रमिंग ऑन द कॉरुगेटेड टिन रूफ. Drumming means that sound which the rain makes when it falls on the corrugated roof. That noise that it makes, you know, falling noisily. You can see the meaning there given at the right hand side of the lesson on that particular page of your textbook. Okay? So, there has been no storm, no thunder, just the steady swish of a tropical downpour. Downpour is the rain. Okay, it helps me to lie awake. At the same time, it doesn't keep me from sleeping. That means he seems to be enjoying the sound of the rain. Yes, he seems to be enjoying. Who? The writer. It is a good sound to read by. The rain outside, the quiet within. And although tin roofs are given to springing unaccountable leaks, there is a feeling of being untouched by and yet in touch with the rain. So that is what his feelings are. So he says there's a feeling of being untouched by. He's inside his house, the rain cannot touch him, and yet in touch with the rain. See, he seems to be imagining, enjoying. That is why in touch with. He's able to see, he's able to feel that noise, that sound of the rain falling on the corrugated roof. That is the reason he says yet in touch with the rain. So now let's move on to August 3rd. Let's see what all things happen. Now this is about 3rd August. August 3rd, the rain stops. So now that it has stopped raining, the clouds begin to break up and the sun strikes the hill on my left. So to his left he can see the sun. A woman is chopping up sticks. I hear the tinkle of cowbells. Tinkle, you know, what are cowbells? You see, some of these cows, you know, what does the owner do? It ties a sort of a bell round its neck. So when it moves, you know, that you can hear the tinkling sound. So that is what it means, the tinkle of cowbells. You must have also seen so many cows with bells around their neck. So when they happen to move a little faster, what happens? You can hear the tinkling sound of the bells. In the oak tree, a crow shakes the raindrops from the feathers and calls. The sound made by the crow is called caw. So it shakes its feathers to keep away from the wetness. So disconsolately, unhappily it is doing that. Yes. Now water drips from a leaking drain pipe and suddenly clean and pure. The song of the whistling thrush. Thrush is the name of a bird. Children, did you notice something? So many birds, names of different types of birds, the writer mentions in this short monsoon diary. Names of lovely, beautiful birds and animals. So thrush is a bird. It is supposed to be singing sweetly, like dark, sweet secret from the depths of the ravine. What is a ravine? It is a valley. Now about August 12th. Endless rain, that means continuously it is raining. That is why it is called endless rain. And a permanent mist, because of that a mist is formed. We haven't seen the sun for 8 or 9 days. That means it has been raining continuously. Everything damp and soggy. See, even if it is not actually wet, you know what happens in the rainy season? Even if your clothes become dry, you touch it, you feel as if it is a little wet, it is a little damp. That is what is called soggy. Nowhere to go. Obviously, in the rain, one cannot go out. Pace the room. Pace means keep walking up and down the room. Look out for the window at a few bobbing umbrellas. Yes, if people have to go out, they obviously have to use their umbrellas. At least it isn't cold. It is not always so that if it rains, it has to become cold. But yes, sometimes it does become cold. No, right now it is raining in Bijapur and it is a bit cold here now. The hillsides are lush. That means it looks so beautiful because it looks all green, flowers and fruits blossoming and blooming. As late monsoon flowers begin to appear, wild balsam. Children, these are names of flowers, okay? Dahlias, begonias, and ground orchids. Ground orchid, you can see in the picture there. That is ground orchid, white color flower. Yes? So these are all names of flowers. Remember that. Now we move on to August 31st. It is the last day of August and the lush monsoon growth has reached its peak. The seeds of the cobra lily, again, cobra lily is what? Name of a flower. The cobra lily are turning red, signifying that the rains are coming to an end. That means when the cobra lily starts blooming, that is an indication of what? That the rains are soon going to come to an end. In a few days, the ferns will start turning yellow, but right now, they are still firm, green and upright. Ground orchids, mauve lady's slipper, these are all names of flowers, and the white butterfly orchids, again these are all white butterfly orchids, you can see there in the picture, put on a fashion display on the grassy slopes of Landrecy. It is as if some fashion show is going on and everybody's, all the flowers are blooming and blossoming and trying to display their beauty. Wild dahlias, red, yellow and magenta. Again, dahlias are flowers. These are different colors of the dahlias. Rear their heads from the rocky crevices. Crevices, narrow openings or cracks in the rock. They seem to be peeping from those cracks where they have taken hold. Snakes and rodents flooded out of their holes. Their holes are full of what you call water because of heavy rain, so they have to come out, they cannot live there. Okay, so what I was telling you that snakes and rodents, their holes are flooded, full of water, even the burrows also. Which animal lives in a burrow? Yes, children, rabbits, hares, they live in burrows. So their holes, their burrows are also full of water. A shrew means what? What is that? It is, you know, okay, I give you the work. That chuchundar it is called, I think so in Hindi. Yes, I am right. So chuchundar, you find out what it is called in Kannada. Right now I am not able to remember, okay? Okay, children, do you know what is a shrew? In your Kannada language, it is hegna, okay? In Hindi, it is chuchundar. So, that is shrew in English. So, I have told you the Hindi word, the Hindi term, what you call in Kannada, okay? So, I hope now I am clear to you. So, don't kill it, admonishes their grandmother. The grandmother is telling, don't kill this, they are supposed to be lucky. They bring money. And sure enough, I receive a check in the mail. See, and immediately after that, after the grandmother tells him, he receives a check in the mail. Not a very large amount, but money is always welcome by one and all. So, here the writer is happy. October 3rd. We have gone straight from monsoon into winter rain. Snow at higher altitudes. Because it is winter, obviously there will be snowfall at the higher altitudes. After an evening hailstorm. Hailstorm, you know, like you feel as if the pieces of small ice is falling. That is actually hail, okay? The sky and hills are suffused with a beautiful golden light. So, you can see a beautiful golden light in the sky. See how beautifully the author gives a description of every minute thing. The flowers, the rodents, the snakes and even the sky. Okay, so now we move on to January 26. Now, this is all about winter rains in the hills. This is what the writer, the author describes here about the winter rains in the hills. Look at the picture there. In the hushed silence of the house, when I am quite alone and my friend who was here has gone, it is very lonely, very quiet as I sit in a liquid silence, a silence within. That means there is absolute silence, no sound, no noise is heard. As earlier the writer said, isn't it, the drumming sound and all that, surrounded by the rhythm of rain. It is only the sound of the rain and as if it is following a rhythmic pattern while falling. The steady drift of what? The fast flow of the water is the steady drift of water on leaves on lemons on roof, drumming on drenched dahlias and window panes. So here basically what is the writer trying to tell? How the rain is falling and where the rain is falling. While the mist holds the house in a dark caress, in a very soothing manner, you know, as I pause near a window, the rain stops. So when he stops near a window, what does happen? What happens? The rain stops and starts again. So it stops and then again it starts raining. And the tree is no longer green, but the trees have turned gray. This is what happens during the winter season. Menace me with their loneliness. Menace me, you know, it is as if it is trying to make him feel very bad, trying to scare him because there's so much of loneliness all around. Late March, end of winter, the blackest cloud I've ever seen squatted over Missouri. Missouri is the name of a place. Squatted means as if it is sitting there. And then it hailed marbles for half an hour. Nothing like a hailstorm to clear the sky. Once again the hailstorm has started. So even as I write, I see a rainbow forming. Generally, when do we see a rainbow? When the sun and the rain appear at the same time, then you get to see, and after the rain stops, what do you see in the sky? Rainbow. Yes, that is a time when you see the rainbow. So now children, I have an interesting video about this chapter. Please watch and enjoy.
August the 2nd. All night, the rain has been drumming on the corrugated tin roof. There has been no storm, no thunder, just the steady swish of a tropical downpour. It helps me to lie awake. At the same time, it doesn't keep me from sleeping. It is a good sound to read by. The rain outside, the quiet within. And although tin roofs are given to springing unaccountable leaks, there is a feeling of being untouched by, and yet in touch with, the rain. August the 3rd. The rain stops. The clouds begin to break up. The sun strikes the hill on my left. A woman is chopping up sticks. I hear the tinkle of cowbells. In the oak tree, a crow shakes the raindrops from the feathers and caws disconsolately. Water drips from a leaking drain pipe, and suddenly, clean and pure, the song of the whistling thrush emerges like a dark, sweet secret from the depths of the ravine. August the 12th. Endless rain and a permanent mist. We haven't seen the sun for 8 or 9 days. Everything damp and soggy. Nowhere to go. Pace the room, look out of the window at a few bobbing umbrellas. At least it isn't cold rain. The hillsides are lush as late monsoon flowers begin to appear. Wild balsam, dahlias, begonias, and ground orchids. August the 31st. It is the last day of August, and the lush monsoon growth has reached its peak. The seeds of the cobra lily are turning red, signifying that the rains are coming to an end. In a few days, the ferns will start turning yellow. But right now, they're still firm, green, and upright. ground orchids, mauve lady slipper, and the white butterfly orchids put on a fashion display on the grassy slopes of Landor. Wild dahlias, red, yellow, and magenta, rear their heads from the rocky crevices where they have taken hold. Snakes and rodents flooded out of their holes and burrows take shelter in roofs, attics, and godowns. A shrew, weak of eyesight, blunders about the rooms, much to the amusement of the children.
"Don't kill it,"
admonishes their grandmother.
"Chuchundars are lucky. They bring money."
And sure enough, I receive a check in the mail. Not a very large one, but welcome all the same. October the 3rd. We have gone straight from monsoon into winter rain. Snow at higher altitudes. After an evening hailstorm, the sky and hills are suffused with a beautiful golden light. January the 26th. Winter rains in the hills. In the hushed silence of the house, when I'm quite alone and my friend who was here has gone, it is very lonely, very quiet, as I sit in a liquid silence, a silence within, surrounded by the rhythm of rain, the steady drift of water on leaves, on lemons, on roof, drumming on drenched dahlias and window panes, while the mist holds the house in a dark caress. As I pause near a window, the rain stops and starts again, and the trees, no longer green but gray, menace me with their loneliness. March the 23rd. Late March, end of winter. The blackest cloud I've ever seen squatted over Missouri. And then it hailed marbles for half an hour. Nothing like a hailstorm to clear the sky. Even as I write, I see a rainbow forming.
By Ruskin Bond.